China has launched an unprecedented mission to retrieve samples from the far side of the moon.
Russia has been struggling to revamp its space program. Now it has found a partner, China.
China plans an urgent magnetic launcher to mine the moon. Imagine a colossal device stationed on the moon, whirling furiously as it prepares to catapult materials back to our planet. Now pause and consider. What if this innovation is the start of a new, darker chapter in global resource control? Stay tuned, because as we delve into China's dangerous lunar ambitions and the unforeseen consequences they may unleash, China's bold plan to transform space mining. At the core of this groundbreaking advancement are Chinese researchers spearheading the development of a cutting-edge magnetic launcher that has the potential to transform space travel and revolutionize space mining. This advanced technology, which could also play a pivotal role in addressing some of Earth's energy challenges, is backed by an enormous investment of $18 billion. A dedicated team is leading the ambitious project from the Shanghai Institute of Satellite Engineering, a leading force in pioneering new methods for space exploration and resource utilization. Their work sets the stage for a future where space could contribute to solving global energy needs. But just as the project was reaching a critical milestone, an unexpected discovery deep within the launch mechanism's core threatened to unravel everything. The very future of space travel hanging in the balance, and what they found next could change the course of history forever. The proposed magnetic levitation facility on the moon operates similarly to the mechanics of a hammer throw in athletics. Picture a rapidly spinning arm that propels materials into space, mimicking the motion of an athlete hurling a hammer. Rather than relying on conventional rocket fuel, this innovative system utilizes magnetic levitation to launch objects, offering a much more efficient and cost-effective method for space transportation. By reducing dependency on traditional fuels, this approach has the potential to significantly lower the expenses associated with moving materials between the moon and Earth, revolutionizing the economics of space travel and resource extraction. The facility will have a 50-meter rotating arm powered by a special superconducting motor. This arm will be able to launch materials at the moon's escape speed in about 10 minutes. Once it's running, it might handle 2 launches each day, sending things like lunar materials back to Earth. The energy for these launches will come from both solar and nuclear sources. Impressively, over 70% of the energy used will be recycled during the slowing down phase of each launch. One of the big goals of this project is to collect and send back helium-3, a rare material on Earth that could be used for clean energy through nuclear fusion. The plan is to mine and return 3 to 5 tons of it every year. Experts believe this could bring huge financial benefits and have a major impact on global energy sustainability. In fact, the iodine found on the moon might be enough to power the world's energy needs for thousands of years. But the challenges are real. The moon's tough environment and the need for a super heavy rocket to bring the system there make this project difficult. Researchers are aiming to finish developing key parts by the year 2030 and hope to fully launch the system by 2045. If successful, this project could revolutionize not just space travel, but also the mining of resources from the moon, pushing us closer to a sustainable off-Earth economy. Could this mark the dawn of a new era in Earth's energy production? While only time will reveal the full impact, the potential benefits are undeniable. This development could fundamentally reshape our perspectives on both space exploration and energy generation. Once regarded primarily as a subject of scientific curiosity, the moon is now being viewed as a critical resource, particularly as nations like China and Russia collaborate on ambitious space initiatives. This partnership underscores the growing recognition of the moon's potential to play a transformative role in solving global energy challenges. China has ambitious plans to establish a research station at the moon's south pole by the year 2035. This station will serve not only as a hub for scientific exploration, but also as a key mining facility, with a particular focus on extracting the rare isotope that holds the potential to revolutionize clean nuclear energy production. According to scientists in Shanghai, a mere 20 tons of it could provide enough energy to power China for an entire year, presenting a possible solution to the nation's growing energy demands. If successful, this project could be the game changer in the quest for sustainable, long-term energy sources. People have shown increasing curiosity about how the magnetic launcher operates and why it has garnered so much attention. The launcher functions entirely on electricity, drawing power from both solar and nuclear energy sources available on the Moon. The Moon's low gravity and absence of an atmosphere make this device remarkably efficient at sending objects back to Earth. Due to these favorable conditions, the launcher significantly reduces the cost of transportation. Scientists estimate that it could launch items twice daily, slashing current transport expenses to just 10% of what they are today. The launcher is a huge machine, weighing about 80 metric tons, which is around 88 US tons. To get it to the Moon, China would use its massive Long March 9 rocket. There are a lot of technical challenges, like the Moon's rough surface and extreme temperatures. But scientists are ready to tackle these issues because the potential rewards are huge. Once up and running, the launcher could keep working for up to 20 years. The idea that it could send valuable resources back to Earth for two decades is pretty amazing. China is particularly interested in the rare material that could change the future of nuclear energy by making nuclear fusion, a cleaner and more efficient energy source, possible. The Moon is one of the best places to find it, making this project even more important. But the real game changer here is that if China can successfully use the rare material, it might lead to a global energy revolution. This could shift the balance of power in the energy world. The project is expected to cost about 130 billion yuan, or around 18 billion US dollars, showing just how serious and ambitious it is. However, the payoff could be just as massive, not only providing the rare material, but also opening up new opportunities for space exploration and mining. Yet, these challenges are just the beginning, and that's not even the toughest part. This device could change how we carry out future missions to other planets and moons, using similar methods to gather and transport resources back to Earth. What once seemed like a dream, turning space into a place rich with resources, is now becoming more real. As we explore the potential of lunar mining, the next chapter will delve into the broader implications for international space collaboration and global energy solutions. Building the magnetic launcher on the Moon. The challenges this bold mission faces are huge. The Moon's rough, bumpy surface and extreme changes in temperature create serious technical problems. These conditions could affect how well the magnetic launcher works and how long it lasts. To overcome this, we'll need strong materials and smart engineering solutions to make sure the launcher performs well over time. Building an 80-ton launcher on the Moon, where conditions are harsh and unforgiving, is a massive task. But China has always been able to meet these kinds of challenges with creativity and determination. With its strong background in space exploration, it is in a good position to tackle these tough problems. Its advancements in material science, robotics, and space technology provide a solid foundation to handle the complex technical needs of this project. Its experience with the Chang'e lunar missions, which have operated under the Moon's tough conditions, proves that it has the ability to manage and overcome space-related challenges. By using advanced technology and working closely with strategic partners like Russia, it is ready to push this groundbreaking project forward. But this wasn't the toughest part yet. Successfully setting up the magnetic space launcher could place it at the front of space exploration and be a big step in the global race for space resources. As it moves forward with its space goals, it's becoming clear that it aims for more than just scientific discovery. This project is a key part of its plan to secure a strong presence in space and tap into its vast resources. The partnership with Russia on the Lunar Research Station highlights the growing importance of working together internationally on space missions. Together, these countries aim to achieve something that once seemed impossible, creating a way to gather resources from space and bring them back to Earth efficiently. This new magnetic space launcher could change the game when it comes to mining resources from the Moon. But that's not even the best part. The launcher will run on solar and nuclear power, meaning it won't need traditional fuel. Because the Moon has very low gravity and almost no air, the launcher can send materials back to Earth twice a day, and it will cost about 10% of what current methods do. In order to launch this entire system, which has an estimated weight of around 80 metric tons, China will require the use of its most powerful rocket, the Long March 9. This formidable spacecraft is essential for transporting the massive equipment into space, marking a critical step in realizing the ambitious plans for lunar exploration and mining. The Long March 9 is key to ensuring the successful deployment of the system, paving the way for future advancements in space-based technologies. Imagine using the Moon's vast resources to help solve Earth's energy problems. Chinese scientists have come up with an exciting idea, a magnetic launcher that could make this possible. This isn't just science fiction, it's a real plan to use new space technology. The launcher is designed to send resources like helium-3, a rare element found on the Moon, back to Earth. The Moon's low gravity and lack of atmosphere make it easier to launch things from there. With this launcher, transportation costs could be reduced by 90%, making lunar mining a highly profitable business. In this explanation, we'll explore how the launcher works, why it's important for our future, and how it could change the way we get energy. So, how does this magnetic launcher work? It takes advantage of the Moon's special environment, its weaker gravity, and almost no air resistance. Think of it like an athlete throwing a hammer in the Olympics. The launcher uses a rapidly spinning arm, powered by a super efficient motor, to throw a capsule full of lunar resources toward Earth. This isn't just a fun idea. Scientists at the Shanghai Institute of Satellite Engineering have been working hard to make it a reality. The launcher uses magnetic levitation, so it runs on electricity and doesn't need any fuel. This makes it simpler and could allow the system to launch materials twice a day. But here's where it gets really interesting. The Moon's escape velocity, or the speed needed to leave its surface, is just 1/6 of what's needed on Earth. That makes this launcher even more cost-effective. The engineers behind this project have figured out how to spin the arm fast enough to reach the Moon's escape velocity of about 2.5 kilometers per second in only 10 minutes. This precision means the capsule is launched on a nearly perfect path, with little need for corrections later. The system is also highly energy efficient, recovering over 70% of the energy used in each launch by converting the motion of the spinning arm back into electricity as it slows down. This is a big improvement over traditional rockets, which waste much more energy. However, the most remarkable aspect lies beyond just cost savings. By harnessing the Moon's abundant resources, we could significantly enhance our capacity to generate energy here on Earth. This advancement would represent a monumental leap toward addressing the pressing energy challenges our planet faces today. Such a breakthrough could pave the way for more sustainable energy solutions, marking a transformative step in the global effort to secure a reliable and efficient energy future for generations to come. Moving forward, let's examine the technological partnerships and innovations that make these ambitious projects feasible. The Moon's role in global power. The Moon's distinct environment has given rise to a groundbreaking system that has the potential to reduce the cost of transporting materials from the Moon to Earth by as much as 90%. This significant reduction in expenses is seen by experts as a game changer, paving the way for more frequent lunar mining operations. As a result, the Moon could become an essential contributor to Earth's energy supply, transforming it into a valuable resource for meeting global energy demands. This innovation may revolutionize how we view the Moon, not just as a distant celestial body, but as a key player in the future of energy production. This is important because of helium-3, a rare material on Earth, but much more common on the Moon. It could change how we produce energy. This substance can be used in nuclear reactors that are much safer and don't create dangerous waste. Just 20 tons could power China for a whole year, and the Moon has more than 1 million tons. This means the Moon could supply energy for the entire world for thousands of years. But this isn't the biggest part. This plan also puts China in the lead for space exploration and high-tech industries. The magnetic launch system is part of a bigger strategy to improve space mining, build stronger launch vehicles, and use artificial intelligence. The money made from mining helium-3 could be huge, and it could even help fund more space exploration in the future. In addition, the magnetic launcher could help with global partnerships, especially with countries like Russia. China and Russia are working together on a plan to build a joint lunar station. They aim to set up a research base at the Moon's South Pole by the year 2035. This base would be key for the magnetic launcher, providing everything needed to gather, process, and send materials from the Moon back to Earth. But the impact could be even bigger. By using this technology in their Moon missions, China and Russia could gain a strong position in the growing space economy. If this project works, it could kick off a new era of space business. Mining helium-3 and other resources on the moon could reduce our need for fossil fuels and push us toward more renewable energy. It could also lead to the creation of new industries like space transportation and off-world manufacturing, making this launcher a big first step toward a lasting presence in space. In the near future, the moon could become a key part of Earth's economy. But like all advanced technologies, the magnetic launcher has its challenges. One of the biggest hurdles is figuring out how to build such a system on the moon's tough surface. The moon's environment is harsh, with extreme temperatures, strong cosmic radiation, and the rough lunar dust, all of which create big risks. The launcher's rotating arm has to be strong enough to move at high speeds while dealing with these tough conditions. Making sure it stays stable, especially when it weighs around 80 tons, is a huge challenge. Moving and putting together the magnetic launcher on the moon is another big problem. China is leading the way, working on huge launch vehicles that can carry these heavy parts into space. But everything depends on these vehicles being successfully sent into space before construction can even begin. The cost for this whole project is massive, or $182 billion. Even though the potential benefits are huge, this upfront cost is still a lot. And if the development of the launch vehicles gets delayed, it could push the project's timeline back by a lot. But this isn't even the most challenging aspect of the situation. As outer space increasingly becomes a valuable business frontier, nations across the globe are fiercely competing to be the first to secure and control the untapped resources that lie beyond our planet. In this race for dominance, the recent collaboration between China and Russia on their magnetic launcher project could have far-reaching implications, potentially altering the entire landscape of space exploration. If these two countries succeed in developing and deploying this technology, they could gain a significant strategic advantage, especially in the hunt for valuable resources on the moon. The moon, believed to hold vast amounts of essential materials like helium-3, rare earth elements, and other critical minerals, could become the next great battleground for economic supremacy. A successful magnetic launcher could dramatically reduce the cost of transporting materials to and from the moon, giving China and Russia a head start in the resource race. Even with all these challenges, there's hope for the magnetic launcher. The system is designed to last for at least 20 years, meaning the early investment could bring long-term rewards. If it works, this project could lead to more breakthroughs in space logistics and resource gathering. It might even push humanity toward deeper space exploration and building human settlements on the moon. This would be a major step forward in our efforts to use the moon's resources. But that's not all. The moon's unique conditions could make this system a cost-effective and energy-efficient way to transport important resources like helium-3 back to Earth. The impact could be huge, potentially changing how we produce energy, boosting the economy, and reshaping the global space race. Of course, the path ahead is filled with difficult engineering problems and political challenges. But if this project succeeds, it could open the door to a new era of lunar business, leading to more innovations and expanding humanity's presence in space. Could this leap in technology ignite tensions in the global power structure as nations compete for off-world resources? Hit like and subscribe for more.